Do you have an M-Audio legacy FireWire device and right now feel stuck because the drivers are no longer being updated? Well, don't throw it away because I've got a solution for you today. I'm going to show you how to connect your M-Audio legacy FireWire device to your Mac running OS El Capitan Sierra or High Sierra. Now, before I start, I want to acknowledge and give credit to this wonderful M-Audio FireWire user support group on Facebook. Everything that I'm going to be saying, I've learned from these guys, so all credit to them. So I just want to acknowledge that. I have the M-Audio FireWire Project Mix, which I would like to connect to my Mac running High Sierra at the moment. So we're going to be following these steps, and by the end, my FireWire should connect and it should work. Now, there are about 7 or 8 steps or so we need to follow. Don't be put off by the number 7 or 8. Most of these steps are very straightforward. They don't require much time, really. However, please follow these steps carefully as outlined and demonstrated in this video. Okay, let's go for it. Step one, download the drivers. I have provided you with the link in the description. Please click on it, follow it, and get the drivers for your own device. Make sure that you store these files at a safe place on your computer, as they will be needed from now on in order for your device to connect with your Mac properly. Before we proceed, please make sure that your FireWire device is off, is disconnected from your computer, and please disconnect any other peripherals from your Mac during this installation. Now, when you download the drivers for your particular device, you'll have the main folder, and inside there should be 3 subfolders. Okay, that's it then. Let's go to step two. Step two, run the uninstall file to remove all M-Audio drivers. Go to the number one subfolder and click on the uninstall MAudioFireWire.pkg and follow the uninstall instructions all the way to the end. Put your password on, click continue. Install, M-Audio FireWire and installer, yes, uninstall, proceed. Yeah, can I ask you to restart? Yeah, click restart. Which takes us to step three, which is we need to enter into the Mac recovery mode and give some instructions to the Mac in order to enable it to allow the device to connect properly. Now, when your Mac restarts, when you hear the chime at the beginning, please press and hold Command R keys at the same time and keep holding them down until the screen goes black and you see the Apple logo appearing. Now, your Mac should now enter into the recovery mode. Now, when you enter the recovery mode, your screen should look like this. You will see this gray screen and Mac OS Utilities pop-up window up there.
We are now ready to move to step four. So over half of the way there, so almost there.
At the top. Here we're going to disable something within the Mac in order to allow the Mac and the device to connect and work together. Just a reminder, please bear in mind that you're responsible for making these decisions. However, it works, and I've done it, and I'll be doing it with you in this video, and my system is just fine. So in recovery mode, go to the top menu, the Mac OS Utilities menu. Under Utilities, open Terminal, and in Terminal, please type CSRUtil in one word. CSRUtil space disable and press enter. You then see this message
successfully disable system integrity protection. Please restart the machine for this to take effect. You need to restart the machine. Yep, go there and click restart. Now, please remember your devices are still not connected to your Mac, so don't connect anything yet. Which takes us to step 5. We are now going to install the M-Audio FireWire drivers. Once again, we go back to subfolder 1 and double-click on the file that says maudiofirewire.mpkg and follow the installation instructions. Yeah, continue and continue, 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 agree, install, put in a password. Once the drivers are installed, you reach this window that tells you to shut down and then connect your devices to your Mac. If you're running El Capitan, go ahead and do that. Just click shut down and then go on to the next stage. If, however, you're running Sierra or High Sierra, please do not do it yet. Just drag this window to the side for the moment. Then open subfolder 2. And within subfolder number 2, you'll find this file that says, run me first and only once. So double click on that. And then it requires you to put in your password. Type your password. It won't be visible, but the system will see it. And then click enter. When you finish, it says completed. Then you can go back to click shut down, and then your system will shut down. Okay, which takes us to step 6. While your Mac is off, connect your FireWire device cable to your device and to your Mac. Don't switch on the Mac yet. Make sure that you switch on your FireWire device before you switch on the Mac. So do all the cable, the connections with everything off, then switch on your FireWire device. When it's fully on, then switch on your Mac. It is not advisable to connect or disconnect your FireWire device when the computer is on. So once your FireWire device is connected to your Mac and is turned on, go ahead, switch on the Mac, and log in as you log in normally into your system. Which takes us to step 7. When your Mac boots and you're in, you may see this window or you may not see it. So don't panic if you don't see it. If you see it, it means that everything's worked just fine. Step 7, almost there. We are going to go to subfolder number 2 once again and load stage 1 command, and then after that load stage 2 command. So let's do it. Double click on load stage 1 and then put in your password. Press enter, and then once it's completed, you can see it says completed, and then double click on load stage 2 command and do the same thing. Password and press enter. And it says completed. Yeah, it means success. You can go ahead and then quit the terminal. And the final step before we test our system is we are going to get rid of the old M-Audio icon from the applications and replace it with the one in the panel subfolder. Okay, first of all, let's open our applications folder and locate the M-Audio icon and throw it into the bin. Then let's open the drivers we downloaded, we've stored in our system, and go to the panel subfolder. Now, copy this M-Audio icon and paste it into the applications folder. So once that is done, from the applications folder, drag on the new icon you've just pasted in. Just drag and drop it on your desktop. So everything is done. So we're now gonna go and test our system. Click and open the M-Audio control panel. And go to System Preferences and choose your FireWire device for output. We are using Project Mix here, so I'm going to choose Project Mix as our output. And then let's try and play something and see if it works. Voila, ladies and gentlemen, it works. The FireWire device is working well with my system. They're working together. Yeah, I'm happy. Now, remember that every time you want to use your FireWire device with your Mac, you will have to run load stage 1 command as well as load stage 2 commands. May sound tedious, but actually just it should become the second nature, really. And finally, for me, I want to check and make sure that my Project Mix is working well with Pro Tools. I'm going through this whole thing because I want to run Pro Tools with Project Mix. I want Project Mix to control Pro Tools. So let's see if everything works. Now I've got a Pro Tools project already open, but the two devices are not connected yet. So I need to go into Pro Tools and change the playback engine and also change the MIDI controller to the Project Mix so that the Project Mix can actually control Pro Tools. And if they will work together, then even the faders will actually work in sync. And let's see if it works. So let's try that. Let's do that. Project Mix, IO. Project Mix command. Yay, it works. The faders have responded. These guys are working together. Press play. Fingers crossed. Yeah, everything working fine. Et voila, Project Mix is taking command of Pro Tools and they're working together in sync. That's it. Thanks for watching. If I had more time, I'd have introduced you to my humble workspace, but maybe next time. Please leave some comments, some suggestions, and leave some encouraging comments. so that I'd be encouraged to make more videos. Thanks for stopping by. Leave some good comments and keep on making music. Keep on making the world happy. Bye.